Students, let us consider by adding two numbers such as 7 plus 8. So what I'll get? So 7 plus 8 is nothing but 15. So what I got? When I added the whole number, I got the whole number as the answer. Similarly, if I add 0 plus 15, so again I'm getting 15. So when I'm adding the whole number, I'm getting the answer as whole number. So from this we can see that the sum of any two whole numbers is a whole number. The collection of whole numbers is closure under addition. And this property is known as a closure property for addition of whole numbers. Similarly for multiplication also we can solve for that. Let us consider the numbers such as 7 and 8. So let us multiply the 7 with 8. So I'm going to get 7 8 is 56. So when I multiply two whole numbers, I got a whole number as the answer. Similarly, if I multiply 0 with 15, I'm getting 0. Again, it is a whole number, right? 0 is a whole number. So I can say that the multiplication of two whole numbers is also found to be the whole number. Again, I can say that the system of whole numbers is closure under multiplication. So what is this closure property? It says that whole numbers are closed under addition and also under multiplication. Now, let us consider for the subtraction and let us see what we will get. Okay, so let us take a number such as, so let me consider 6 and 2. Okay, so if I do 6 minus 2, how much I'm gonna get? I'm gonna get 4. So when I subtracted this two whole number, I got whole number. Fine, let me consider one more example then. So let us consider 7 minus 8. So 7 minus 8 is minus 1. But this minus 1 is not a whole number, right? It's a negative number. So I can see that the subtraction of two whole numbers is not always a whole number. So the whole numbers are not closed under subtraction. Similarly, let's see for division also. So let us take an example. 8 divided by 4. So what I'll get? I'll get 2 as the answer. So which is a whole number? So fine. Let me consider one more example then. So let us consider 5 divided by 7. So how much I'm gonna get? So 5 divided by 7 is nothing but 5 by 7. It's not a whole number, right? Yeah. So similarly, like subtraction also, here for division as well, always we will not get the whole number. And if I divide the number by 0, for example, 0 by 8, it is called as not defined. So from this I can see that the whole numbers are not closed under division. All to all I can say that whole numbers are not closed under division and subtraction. It is only closed under addition and multiplication. Okay, so this is about one property, closure property. So in the next class, let's see the commutative property.